what's going on right now in the locker room, if you can kind of describe the emotions and feelings going on right now.
Well, guys are cleaning up as we speak. We're trying to just get a clean locker room, take care of the little things. Just kind of trying to, I think that the whole attitude right now is, regroup and rebuild. And, like I said, there's going to be a lot of film watching going on tomorrow, I think. And I don't think anybody's happy with the way they played tonight. So we're going to have to move on from it, obviously, and just learn what we can and move forward.
Front left, Jerry.
Tyler, most people feel games are won at the line, loss at the line of scrimmage. I mean, I assume you felt like your effort was 100%. Was that where the game was lost on both sides of the ball, you think? I know there was other little mistakes, but...
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to say from a defensive standpoint. And they're out there. We're trying to do what we can to repair what's gone wrong in previous series as an offensive line. For us, it just seemed like we couldn't all really get on the same page as far as, those first down, or when it was first and 10. We very rarely had a positive play. Like I said, that starts up front. That starts normally. Those are obviously going to be your run plays, your play actions, and like I said, I don't think the effort was the issue. I think it when it comes down to it was just lack of communication, lack of technique, and just lack of focus overall.
Tyler, what have you guys said in the locker room since the game as a group of players? And what do you plan to do or talk or meet about between now and when you get back on the practice field?
The biggest thing right now is just we need to get back to the culture of Oregon football. We didn't display that tonight, obviously, and a group of us leaders, we've already been talking about what we're going to do to fix things, and we're working on figuring that out right now. Like I said, obviously, that outcome, nobody's happy with that. Nobody's happy with how they played individually or as a team, as a group. As an offensive line unit, as a defensive line unit, nobody's pleased with anything right now. So, like I said, we're just going to fix the culture, find the holes, and plug them up a little bit.
Hey, Tyler, often coaches talk about, leaders, and leaders are often your best players, mm-hmm. veteran players and so forth. Well, yeah. Two quarterbacks, I mean, I probably don't need to tell you, are a little bit inconsistent right now at Oregon. How do you rally around that? Because often leadership is, the quarterback is part of that mm-hmm. leadership group and so forth. And right now, maybe you don't know who's going to even play in the next game.
Yeah, I mean, that doesn't, as far as us goes, I mean, it might be hard for you to believe, that doesn't really matter to the rest of the team that much. That matters for obviously those two guys playing, but whoever has that spot, whoever's in at the time, we expect them to perform at the exact same level as anybody who obviously is going to be playing that spot. The rest of us, we're going to do our job regardless who's back there. I'm not just going to blow my technique because Jeff Lockyer is back there, Vernon Adams is back there, Taylor Alley. It doesn't matter who's back there. We're going to do our job and to the best of our ability and hopefully get first downs, get touchdowns, and just put together, just put together full drives. Like I said, it doesn't matter too much who's back there or not.
Was there any hint of anything during the week or a cause for concern leading into the game in the back of your mind?
Not really. I mean, a lot of times you get that feeling kind of and throughout the week, and you can't really put your finger on it. You feel like everybody's giving their all, but there's something kind of in the back of your head. You're like, we might lose this game. That's happened before. I think that happened in the Arizona game, like to my redshirt sophomore year, when we lost kind of similar to this down in Arizona. I kind of had that feeling that week, but this week wasn't the case. Like I said, we're going to have to go on film and see what happened. Like I said, just obviously did not play to our standard, didn't play Oregon football whatsoever. And so, extremely disappointed and we're going to have to see what we can learn from it.
Is this maybe more about Utah being more of a kind of badass team than people realize around the country?
They are a great team, and that's to be said, I'm not trying to take away anything from their win. They played on all cylinders tonight. And they are a very good team, very physical team, very well coached. But the problem was we didn't show up in any phase, offense, defense, special teams. That's what ultimately killed us. To beat Utah, you're gonna have to play well in all three phases, and they're probably a little bit underrated right now. But like I said, we have everything we can to beat. We have the tools to beat them. We just didn't play well on any in any part of the game.
Tyler, there's probably going to be some people around the country who look at this game and say, this isn't the same Oregon team without Marcus and Hronas and Ifo and some of the guys you lost.
Yeah.
Do you feel like there's truth in that, or do you feel like you guys still have the pieces to be that kind of team?
I mean, it's 100% true. We're not the same team we were with, you know, those guys. Those guys moved on. You know, guys stepped up. So, I mean, by definition, we're a different team. But I mean, we have all the tools to be just as good as we always have been. Like I said, we didn't really show up tonight, and things fell through. You know, but we have trust in the guys we have here now. And like I said, I've said it a few times. I mean, there's going to be a lot of film watching tomorrow, a lot of things we can learn. And we're just going to have to push forward and see what happens.
Anything else?
Great. Thanks, Thank you.